Every time I need to host a project nowadays, I keep coming back to the same type of web hosting, and that's managed cloud hosting. It's extremely fast, incredibly flexible with upgrade or downgrade options at any time, and it just has so much potential. But there aren't that many providers to choose from because it does have its downsides. Cloudways is arguably the one that popularized this type of service. Once you buy a Cloudways plan, you can select what type of software you plan to use, for example, WordPress. Then you choose which server provider you like to use. Currently, you can choose from DigitalOcean, Vulture, Linode, AWS, or Google Cloud. And then you specify how many resources you want for that server to have, and if you're going for the premium or standard versions. Keep in mind that you can see your monthly price here at the bottom, and it goes up quite fast with more resources. Cloudways and all managed cloud hosting platforms are not cheap when compared to standard shared web hosting services. After you're done, your server gets configured automatically. That's part of the managed service, so you'll spend more time waiting for automation to happen rather than browsing through menus and configuring or tweaking everything yourself. Of course, the truly best part about using Cloudways is that you don't get charged upfront, like nothing at all. For example, I currently paid $0 for this server. It's brand spanking new, and this has nothing to do with the 3-day free trial that Cloudways is offering if you use the link in the description. Instead, Cloudways bills based on hours used. Of course, in a regular scenario, your server runs 24/7 for the whole month, keeping your projects online, so the price adds up to be exactly what you saw during setup. But since it's currently been 0 hours, if I go to my real-time billing section, and I can see that my current bill is $0. So if you want, just get the trial, load up a test server, check it out for yourself, and it gets deleted after 3 days if you don't buy anything. Even after the trial, this allows you to experiment with expensive and high-end configuration and delete your servers anytime you want. So if you've ever been in a situation where you don't exactly know how much resources or power your website needs, you can use Cloudways to get a feel for it. Just keep maxing out that slider until your website works smoothly for the load you're putting on it. Because this way, you either end up paying nothing or you pay for only what you've used. Additionally, this allows you to change the parameters of your server without having to set up new accounts on multiple web hosting companies or buy more expensive packages, like with other web hosting providers where you just buy a one-size-fits-all package, and if you prepaid for 3 years, now it's gonna sit wasted since you'll need to buy another package instead of upgrading and then transfer your site over. It's a huge hassle, and I've dealt with this exact problem multiple times in the past, so having these resources that are scalable is basically the best thing you can have for your project. Wow. Because this allows you to stay in control. Maybe keeping your server on low power but low cost mode for weekdays, but boosting it up on weekends when you see additional traffic coming in, or on holidays as well as sales. But don't fall into the trap of thinking, I have to keep my server at maximum power at all times, because more resources does not make your website faster. It just makes it so it doesn't slow down when more people visit it at the same time. So even at the minimal resource power, your website will be the same speed as if with the maximum if there's only a couple of people visiting your website at the same time. To prove this point, I've actually loaded in a test website on my 1 GB premium DigitalOcean plan for $14 a month, and the same exact website in the 4 GB plan for $54 a month. Here, you can see the website's loading pages in real time. To me, they roughly seem the same. But on this channel, we do objective data-based research, so I did load up Google PageSpeed and tested both the $54 a month website and the $14 a month website. And yeah, they both scored 91 out of 100 on desktop. The cheaper website was actually even faster by 0.1 second compared to the 4GB option. But of course, there are some variations on each individual test. So to me, everything this says is that both plans are virtually identical when testing with a low user count. In this case, just one. By the way, at this point, I wanted to test these websites for a longer period of time. So it has been 48 hours since I set up both of them. And if I go to my real-time billing section, I have been billed $4. So if I were to delete my servers right here, I would only pay $4. And that's it. But if I were to keep using both servers for the rest of the month, my estimated bill is around $63. That's exactly why I love managed cloud hosting. You can just create a project and delete a project and you only pay for what you use instead of buying a pre-made bundle that maybe you'll use, maybe you won't use, and it's just gonna sit there that you paid money for it and now it's wasted. So there are no questions in my mind that Cloudways is an excellent service when it comes to website speed and reliability. The real question is, should you pay double the rate for using Cloudways instead of getting one of the Cloudways offered servers from DigitalOcean, Vulture, Linode, AWS, or Google directly? And are there any better similar options on the market right now? Okay, as for buying directly, I do have a DigitalOcean plan right here. Yes, it is half the price of Cloudways if I end up buying directly. But you would need at least some technical skills to manage all of this because yes, it's cheaper, but it's more technical, way more technical. You need to know how to use the terminal because after your server is initialized, it's completely empty. You need to log in using SSH and your server IP. And once you're in, this is your control panel. You need to install everything manually. And yes, there are tutorials available, for example, on how to install WordPress. You can just copy and paste the commands in and research as you go, but there's no automation. So in my opinion, yes, it is worth to buy directly. If you're willing to learn or have the skills directly, Cloudways won't help you much in this case. But if this does not look like your cup of tea and you're just not gonna bother with all of this hassle, then yeah, Cloudways will give you the performance of a custom service just like this with none of the technical difficulties of having to manage your own security, updates, packages, operating systems, etc. And yeah, they're gonna charge you double for this convenience. It's not out of the kindness of their heart. And that's essentially the Cloudways business model. They take complicated, cheap stuff and they make it easy, but expensive. Actually, let's talk about the price, since it's gonna be a bit more than double. Due to critical website-related features, you simply do not get for free, like a website name. Yep, Cloudways does not even sell those, but you can attach a website name you bought anywhere else. For example, I have a domain called Emit.Reviews.com on Hostinger. So I can create two free subdomains called Cloudways 1GB and Cloudways 4GB, then attach those to my server using the IP address. It sounds complicated, but it's a very simple process. In the end, if you didn't have a name already, that would have costed you like an extra $1 a month. Then there are emails. If you're running a business, you don't want to send emails from gmail.com or yahoo.com. Since you're paying for a website name and a server, you want to use that website name and server to host emails and send emails. Cloudways charges another $1 a month per email box, so this can add up quite fast if you do need a lot of custom email addresses for your employees or different services that you offer. While other solutions usually have email included for free, up to 100 email boxes. So, if we take this into consideration, the cheapest Cloudways configuration for a professional website would be around $13 a month. That's for hosting, website name, and emails. And you get 1GB of RAM and one CPU core. While competitors like Scala Hosting come in at around $13.45 for the full package with double the resources. but you can't pay monthly. You need to prepay for 3 years in advance. There's also Rocket.net, $30 a month for unlimited power, but limited visitor counts. So if you ever get more traction, you'll be forced to upgrade. And SiteGround is around $100 a month. Yeah, you get like 5 times more resources because they just don't offer cheaper tiers. But that's $100 a month. Damn, that's an expensive package. And from my knowledge, these are the biggest competitors of Cloudways. So if you want to truly pay monthly and have full control over how much or how little you're spending, Cloudways really does offer the best package here. I would consider getting Scala hosting if upfront payments are not an issue for you, but for flexible payment options and a similar level of power as well as ease of use, Cloudways really does not have a lot of equals in the market right now. Maybe even none, at least from what I know. And if you value convenience more than the money in your pocket, I would even suggest looking into Cloudways Autonomous, where you essentially skip choosing how many resources you need and you don't manage those resources individually. You pay a fixed $35 a month fee, and then Cloudways scales your server resources up or down based on demand automatically. So when your website does not have a lot of users on it, the server scales down. If you hit a surge of users, the website automatically scales up. So no users get any errors and everyone experiences a smooth ride. This is especially good for e-commerce stores when you run ad campaigns. It is more expensive, but further removes the need to constantly monitor your usage. Essentially, Cloudways is very eager to take money away from you and in exchange make website-related stuff more convenient to the point where you don't even need to look at it. So let's summarize what you get and what you don't get and should you get what you get. You get a truly top-of-the-line server with performance that's able to handle any kind of website. I'm talking news sites, blogs, e-commerce, personal portfolios, anything you can think of. Cloudways can scale up to that point where it's not gonna be a problem. You get an easy to use control dashboard. So instead of using the terminal to manage your server, you can do everything via the dashboard, where you just need your mouse and click on buttons and stuff works. You also get dedicated live chat support to help you with issues if clicking buttons on the dashboard seems complicated or doesn't work. But compared to traditional and usually cheaper web hosting companies like Hostinger or Scala Hosting, you don't get a website name that's included in the package, you don't get any emails that you can set up for free, and you don't have any website creation tools like Hostinger's drag and drop website builders, which is a big draw for like new website builders, just having the ability to make your website in the easiest way possible, not just host it in the easiest way possible. I wouldn't recommend Cloudways to first-time website owners, just because it's like buying an excavator when you need to dig up a tomato plant. A shovel will do. Get cheap web hosting instead. But for people who are looking for a pay-as-you-go option, when they control the server resources and spending, it still remains one of the best managed hosting solutions on the market right now. If you do decide to use Cloudways, you can find a 3-day free trial in the description down below and a guide on how to set it all up right here. Or here, but it's probably here, I think. Anyways, good luck creating your websites, and I hope to see you in the next video.